Guys, Marina here from Yes to Tech. Welcome to Tech Tuesday, where I remove the tech stress that comes along with running a successful online business. Today we're going to talk about MailChimp versus ConvertKit, and which one is the best email marketing software for you. I've used both MailChimp and ConvertKit in my online business, so I understand firsthand the pros and cons that each one offers. Are you currently using either one? I'd love to hear your answer in the comments section below. Stay tuned until the end of this video to discover which email marketing software is best for you and to get a free 30-day trial of ConvertKit. Also, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell to be notified every Tuesday when I post a new video. Alright, so let's get into the MailChimp versus ConvertKit debate. Number 1. How they manage your audience. MailChimp is a list-based system, which means that it segments your subscribers based on lists you create, such as one for those who opted in for a freebie and one for those who purchased your products. The issue with this is that if a subscriber is on more than one of these lists, say both on the freebie opt-in and on the purchased products list, that person counts as two people in your subscriber account, which also makes it harder to tag and segment your subscribers. The only advantage with this is if you're running two businesses under the same account and you can keep your two email lists separate. ConvertKit, on the other hand, has a subscriber-based system, which means that you have a master list of subscribers and can differentiate between those using tags and segments. For instance, once a subscriber opts into your email list, they can be tagged as something and then tagged as something else once they purchase a product. Even if a subscriber has multiple tags attributed to them, they only count as one person in your subscriber account. Number 2. Automation capabilities. Although both MailChimp and ConvertKit have automation capabilities, the one in ConvertKit is more user-friendly because of its visual nature and ease of use due to its tagged and segmented subscribers. MailChimp has a number of predefined automation sequences you can choose from to build your brand, sell more stuff, and boost customer loyalty. In ConvertKit, you can create both a visual automation and automation rules for a number of triggered events, such as subscribes to a sequence, subscribes to a form, completes a sequence, clicks a link, tag added, tag removed, and purchases a product. Number 3. Email broadcasts. MailChimp has more than 100 templates that you can choose from if you're on the Essentials plan or above, be it to drive app downloads, to welcome new subscribers, to release a new product, or to promote a sale. And you can repurpose those emails into social media posts and ads. This may make them look great, but affect their deliverability rates, which means that not all of your subscribers will be receiving your emails. This is because MailChimp is very image-heavy, which makes our receiving email marketing platforms mark their emails as spam. ConvertKit doesn't offer any predefined templates, but you can create and send broadcasts to a very specific segment of your list and customize said broadcast from the legacy editor. You can also A/B test your email subject line, and ConvertKit recently released its new editor, which makes inserting any new element you wish a breeze. Number 4. Customer support. MailChimp has a knowledge base that you can search for if you have any issues with their platform, but its technical support team is a paid feature only, meaning that when you're opting for the free plan, you're not getting much in return. Whenever you have a question about a ConvertKit feature or if something isn't working, you can contact their support team right from your account. And their team will typically reply in a few hours. There's even live customer support chat, So you don't have to wait up to one business day for their team to answer your query by email. Number 5, pricing. MailChimp is free for up to 2,000 subscribers, whereas ConvertKit's cheapest plan starts at $29 per month for up to 1,000 subscribers. That's why when most people who are just starting out with their online businesses gravitate towards MailChimp. However, MailChimp's free plan includes just the basics, and you'll have to opt in for a paid plan if you want to use more advanced features like segmentation, automation series, and A/B testing. Regardless of which plan you're using on in ConvertKit, you'll get absolutely all of the same features without any limits. As such, although MailChimp may be great for beginners who don't want to invest in their businesses upfront, I doubt you'll still be using it in a few months or years down the road as your business grows. Now you know all about MailChimp versus ConvertKit and the pros and cons of both email marketing softwares. Based on what we talked about today, it's pretty clear that I prefer ConvertKit. To make your decision easier, when you click on the link in the description box below, you'll get a free 30-day trial of ConvertKit, so you can test the software out before settling on either platform. So, which software did you choose? Leave your answer in the comment section below, and make sure to click on the link in the description box below to get your free 30-day trial of ConvertKit. If you liked this video, give me a like below, share it with your friends, and make sure to subscribe and hit the bell to be notified every time we post a new video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.